My name is Conan Salada, and I'm running for the two-year Ward 4 City Councilor seat. Keene, New Hampshire, it's a great little community, and it has so much going for it, so much potential, and that's why I live here. And because I do care about preserving and maintaining all the good qualities the city has to offer, I've decided to once again put my name in the hat in order to give back what I can, and to represent that portion of our community that would rather our city leaders spent more time focused on eliminating potholes and less time virtue signaling to the drafting of what seems an endless supply of non-binding resolutions that don't represent the sentiment of the community as a whole. But even more importantly, I'm running to focus on Keene's biggest issue, one that will tear this community apart if it isn't addressed. Of course, I speak of Keene's unsustainable spending habits, currently leading to the third highest tax rate in the state. Ever since I've lived here, Keene officials on both sides of the aisle have claimed endlessly that the silver bullet solution to our high tax rate problem is to simply increase the tax base. The problem is, even if our illustrious city planners managed it, it still won't work to accomplish the desired effect of reducing what you and I pay the city every year. Let me explain why. There are two schools of thought on this tactic of tax base expansion. First and most popular involves actually putting more assets onto the tax rolls, single-family homes, rental properties, and especially businesses. This would and does work, but how much yearly development are we actually talking about? In 2017-18, the city, school, and county budgets in Keene increased by a whopping $1.8 million. Let's put this number into perspective. Home Depot is assessed at $11.2 million. And most likely employs around 100 associates. In order to have balanced out 2017's budget increase, the city of Keene would have needed to add four Home Depots to the tax rolls, four of them, a year. And let's delve even further into the unseen. The city would have needed to produce 400 new employees, homes for them to live in, and all the essential services they're going to expect to receive. Let's try this in single-family homes. In 2017-18, in order to have offset the tax rate increase, the city would have needed to add 314 $150,000 homes. It's not happening. The second tactic involves improving the desirability of the city, which would lead to an increase in the overall assessed value of properties in Keene. It's called gentrification. Property is worth more, thus generating more tax revenue, and the tax rate goes down, right? Except now your property is worth more, the tax rate may be lower, but you're still getting the same bill. But wait for it. Now you're paying for all those new improvements that the city foolishly bonded out for. So yeah, you're still going to pay more. So the city has a spending problem. What do we do? Where do we start? Rule number one, admit that it's actually a problem. Keene has a spending problem, not a revenue problem. Sadly, too many of our elected leaders either don't believe it, or they're simply clueless on how to deal with it. But it's actually very simple. When our city manager and department heads, all employees of the taxpayers of Keene, mind you, and make very good money to make hard decisions, when they bring out the New Year's budget and CIP, you simply say, no, take it back and reduce it by 5%. You and I, the taxpayers, are forced to make cuts to our family budgets every year in order to accommodate the larger tax bill that is forced upon us, or else we lose our homes. Why is it so difficult to imagine our government, which supposedly works for us, why is it so difficult to imagine them doing the same? I'll leave you one thing before I sign off. It's actually a comment often made by one of the current city councilors, and it is so ironic because he's a big part of the problem. They say insanity is repeating the same tired steps but expecting different results. Keene cannot spend its way out of this mess. They've been trying it for decades, and here we are. If you truly want to attract businesses to this region, if you want to keep graduates from moving back to their home states, if you want to keep seniors in their homes and attract younger families with their kids to this area, we must tackle the elephant in the room, and that is the taxes. And as I have discussed, it will not be solved through tax-based expansion, but only through a common-sense approach to what this community can and cannot afford. My name is Conan Salada, candidate for Ward 4, City Council. Thank you.